Let's face it, a lot of artist resources are expensive. Software is often very expensive to buy or has critical features hidden behind a monthly subscription. And finding high quality, free resources to study from can be exhausting. But worry not, my friends, because I put together a list of the best free resources to help you achieve your artistic potential. Now, this is a three-part series covering the best free software, the best free online resources for study, and the best free online educators. So today we're going to look at the best free software available for artists. Everything I list will have its links in the video description. And remember, if you found this video helpful, smash like and subscribe for more videos to come. The support I've gotten so far has been crazy, and it means the world to me. So thank you. And one last thing, I would love it if you would comment any other resources that I've missed. It will help others find valuable, free resources so they can improve their art. Okay, on to the free software, and I think we can all guess where this is gonna start. You've heard me say it before, and I will say it again. Blender! For those who don't know, Blender is a free, open-source 2D and 3D toolkit that can do pretty much anything. Blender tops this list simply because of the overall potential to empower you as an artist. Now, I hear you, there is a big learning curve to Blender, but believe me when I say that the time spent learning to do what you want inside a Blender will be rewarded with
phenomenal cosmic power.
With a basic understanding of the tools that Blender offers, you can create 2D or 3D pieces of art, animation, product renderings, sculptures, the list goes on and on. My recommendation is to get on Blender ASAP, seriously. The sooner you get started, the sooner you'll recognize it for the playground it is.
Krita!
Krita is a free and open source digital art program very similar to Photoshop and Clip Studio Paint. Krita can do pretty much anything an artist asks of it. You can illustrate beautiful works, draw comics, just sketch, and even animate. The software is totally free, very user-friendly, and it is continuously being updated by the developers. If you're interested in learning digital art and want a very powerful, free tool with which to learn, I highly recommend Krita.
PureRef!
One of the best tools for reference because of its simplicity. You can drag and drop images to use as references, add notes to keep things organized, make the screen transparent for studies, shrink the screen and lock it if you're on a single monitor, and a lot more. Very clean, very useful, and totally free. I simply wouldn't recommend anything else for saving and using references.
Inkscape!
Inkscape is designed for vector graphics, so it's often cited as a free alternative to Adobe Illustrator. Vector graphics are extremely useful when you need to have an image stay crisp and well-defined at any scale. Vector art generally has a very distinct style, and if this is of interest to you, then Inkscape is the perfect tool for your needs. The skills you learn in Inkscape will transfer to any other vector graphics programs, so if you switch software in the future, you'll still be set. Plus, it has the added bonus of being really easy to make stickers.
OBS!
OBS, or Open Broadcast Software, lets you record and broadcast your screen. This is an absolute staple for content creators everywhere. But for artists, OBS is profoundly helpful for learning how you work, where you lose focus, and what your strengths and weaknesses are. Just like professional athletes and gamers will watch replays of their own games to improve, artists can also benefit from recording themselves. Think of it like a personal coach that helps you remember the decisions you made while working on a piece of art. Remembering our decisions is important because we artists often associate feelings with the state of an artwork when we put it down. But it's very important to remember how we got there. Recording yourself can help you learn about your own decision making and thus improve your art even faster.
Kinovia!
Kinovia is a free video annotation program. I only just recently discovered it and I'm still learning how to use it, but so far it's an incredible study tool for animation. You can import video and annotate it in any way that's useful to you, which makes it an amazing free study tool.
DaVinci Resolve!
DaVinci Resolve is a free video editing software from Blackmagic. This software is incredibly useful to anyone who wants to make videos or animations, as it allows you to very easily and intuitively edit video and audio. You can color grade, apply effects, pretty much everything you could want. While some very few features are locked behind a paywall, it's actually kind of insane that this type of video editing suite is available for free, as DaVinci Resolve's market competitors either require a costly monthly subscription or cost thousands of dollars to license outright. I highly recommend DaVinci Resolve for people who want a super powerful video editing suite for free.
GIMP!
GIMP is designed for image manipulation, so it's often cited as a free alternative to Adobe Photoshop. GIMP has many of the standard features of Photoshop, and while its toolset is less powerful and comprehensive than its paid counterpart, it has enough tools for beginners to learn the basics of photo manipulation. It's a great option if you want to edit photos or make things like posters and thumbnails. And the skills you learn while using GIMP will remain useful should you move on to paid software in the future.
Darktable!
Darktable is designed for image retouching and finishing, and is often cited as an alternative to Adobe's Lightroom. If you're planning to touch touch up an illustration or 3D rendering and need to do some advanced image retouching, Darktable is an excellent, free, fully featured option. Here's the before and after of a final render as an example. Darktable and GIMP also play rather well together, so it's a nice combination for photo editing.
Conclusion!
And that concludes part one of the free resources series. Stay tuned, because in the next video, we're going to look at free online tools for study and reference. My sincere thanks to everyone who stuck around to the end of the video, and I will see you in the next one. Deuces!